many courses on linear algebra, the theory is explained using real-valued vectors in real-valued matrices first. And then at some point in the course, it gets a little awkward, because when you start talking about eigenvalues and eigenvectors, then inherently complex values sneak in. Since often problems are complex valued anyway, in this course, we're just going to bite the bullet and talk about complex vectors, complex valued matrices from the beginning. Okay. And that means you have to remember a little bit about how complex arithmetic works, but it's really not going to complicate things all that much. And, you know, when push comes to shove, if you just go and you do the problems where you restrict yourself to the real valued problem, it's okay. You'll learn everything that you need to learn. So you'll be all right. Now, the fact that we're going to talk about complex numbers also allows us to kind of introduce the concept of norms with something you've seen before, the absolute value of a number, which will then kind of smoothly allow us to introduce vector norms and then eventually matrix norms. So, let's review. We have a complex number chi. Chi, what's that? That's a lowercase Greek letter, chi. And in our course, so that you can easily recognize when we're talking about a scalar, we're always going to use lowercase Greek letters to denote scalars. So immediately, when you see this, as long as you can see the distinction between an x and a chi there, you recognize that as being chi. Oh, that's a scalar. Now, a complex number is broken down into its real part and its complex part. And remember that this number I is really the square root of minus 1. Okay. And at some point you also learned that there's something called the complex conjugate of a number, and that's just a matter of changing the plus to a minus. Now, how do we measure the magnitude of a complex number? Well, often we visualize complex numbers by taking the complex plane and then placing the complex number in the complex plane, where the x-coordinate is the real part and the y-coordinate is the imaginary part. All right? Now, the magnitude of a complex number then is the distance from that number to the origin. And somewhere you learned about the Pythagorean theorem, and you may have been introduced to this as the Euclidean length. And the distance from here to here then is given by the square root of the real number plus the complex number. All right? Square. I shouldn't call it the complex number. Okay. Real part, complex part, except that this is usually considered. You get the point. All right. So, this is the absolute value of chi. Okay? Now, just as a little side note, notice that if you multiply the complex number times its conjugate, you get the square of this right here. So, an alternative way of computing the absolute value of a complex value number is to multiply the conjugate of chi times chi, and then taking the square root of that. And that can be easily checked. All right, now, the absolute value is a simple example of a norm. Okay, what kind of properties does the absolute value have? Well, think of it as a function that takes as input a complex number, and out pops a real number. And what do we know about that real number? Well, as long as what you put in is not the number zero, then its distance to zero is greater than zero. That's known as the norm is positive definite. Also, notice that if you take a complex number and scale chi with that, and then you take its absolute value, you get the same number as if you do the absolute value of alpha times the absolute value of chi. That's known as the homogeneity property of the absolute value. And finally, if you add two complex numbers together and then you take their absolute value, then you get a number that's less than the absolute value of chi plus the absolute value of psi. This is the Greek lowercase letter psi. And that's known as the triangle inequality. Okay. And a function from some domain to the reals that is positive definite, homogeneous, and obeys the triangle inequality is an order.